Hi, me again. If you don't know, my name's Abby and I'm a third year medical student at the University of Warwick. In fact, not just a third year, but very much bridging up to my final year. I will have taken my finals and know my results by this time next year. So we are very getting close to being a doctor. However, I want to record these videos because there's nothing out there at the moment for people like me. When I say people like me, I mean people on the ASD spectrum, which is the autistic spectrum disorder. I was diagnosed when I was 18, in fact, 5 days after I turned 18, and I'm currently 24 and absolutely loving my degree. But one of the things I did notice I was lacking was that kind of source of information for people like me who do require that little bit of extra detail and extra planning and knowing what to do. So I thought I'd record these videos to help the future generations of ASD doctors coming through, and of course anyone else out there who's finding these videos helpful. I want to talk about the first day today, and this is very daunting, and I remember having a sleepless night before it because I didn't know what to expect. And my first day was even more awkward because I had been off the first 2 weeks of clinical education with a rather nasty ear infection, which wasn't fun. So my first day was on a geriatric ward, and I was lucky enough to have a really lovely consultant. And my clinical partner already knew the consultant quite well, so it was a nice bridge in for me. Your ward, you will either be given a lot of details about your ward or nothing at all. If you've been given a name of a consultant, I recommend emailing beforehand. Always address the consultant with either Dr. XX, so dear doctor, or dear Mr. Ms. or Mrs. Mr. Ms. or Mrs. will be for a surgeon who is kind of, I don't know, the way it got described to me was a surgeon today, which was a bit of, generally a more senior surgeon. If you don't know what to address them, a quick Google search is all you need. 9 times out of 10, your medical school will have given you, oh, Mr. Smith is your consultant. Email them beforehand, and you email them a couple, maybe 2 weeks beforehand, and that means you've got those 2 weeks to email again if they haven't replied. Ask them what time their ward round is, ask them what time their clinic is, and get to find out a little bit more. If you are struggling, you can always turn up to your ward before your clinical rotation starts. Obviously, be aware of COVID restrictions and try to turn up at a time that's not busy. Or most wards have phone or email. You can use that to find out a little bit more information. So find out what time the ward round is. The ward round is a huddle in the morning where generally the consultant leads the ward round. The doctors who are there on the day will go with them, and generally one of the nurses, and you can help shadow on the ward round. You go around and see every patient in the ward, and you review them, see what needs doing, and make a plan for the day. This is excellent to get to know the patients on the ward and who might be good for looking at clinical later. Depending on the consultant, it might also be an excellent source of teaching. So if you're on a cardiac ward, some murmurs might be pointed out. If you're on a gastro ward, you might be encouraged to do an abdominal examination to feel a hernia. Again, this depends on the consultant. Don't always expect it because it depends on busyness and whether the consultant likes teaching or not. But it's a really good way to get familiarised, especially on the first day with the ward. After the ward round, it can be a little bit sticky there, because if the ward round's gone on that long enough, then the patients will start having lunch, and mealtime is protected on the ward, so you do not do anything while the patient is eating. So it can be a bit awkward, but this is a really good time to maybe go off and get lunch yourself. But I'd always ask doctors who are around, and generally this is the FY1, most people have badges that say their grade. If they just say doctor, ask them. Are there any bloods that need doing? Are there any cannulas? Is there anyone that's good for an examination? These are really good questions to ask. Bloods can be a bit iffy because generally the phlebotomist would have come and done them before the ward round. Cannulas only if you are competent enough. Remember, anything you do on the ward, only do it if you're comfortable enough, well, competent enough to do it. Once you come back from lunch, again, the afternoons are generally more when paperwork and things get done, but it's a really good opportunity to go around, take histories of patients, talk to patients, examine patients, and FY1s are amazing at teaching, and so most often than not, if you go and ask them something, they'll go, right, go and have a chat with Mr. XX, and we can have a chat about their condition when you get back. Unfortunately, it can be hard to predict how busy or lax a day will be, and it is something that still takes some getting used to me. It's taken me a year to figure out how exactly I can manage on the ward. But generally, people are lovely and will always be happy to help. Remember to find out when clinics are, remember to find out when, particularly if you've got a surgeon for a consultant, when they might be operating. If you've got an anaesthetist consultant, find out if they're doing labour ward a day. If you can, remember, there are other healthcare professional students, this includes midwives, who are higher up on the priority list than labour ward because they have to help give birth to a certain amount of babies to complete their degree. So always give way to them. Also find out if your anaesthetist consultant has a pain clinic. No one is ever gonna criticise you for asking. People are happy to help, and that is a really big barrier to get over. Once you're happy chatting and asking questions, you'll be absolutely fine. So good luck on your first day. I can honestly say I love my clinic days now. I love talking to patients, and I can't wait for being a doctor. Thank you very much for watching. If you do have any questions or comments about what videos you'd like to see, whack them in the box down below. If you're a healthcare professional watching these videos and would like to help, maybe record some yourself or record some with me, please reach out. I am so happy to help. So thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!